So, hallo. Heute probieren wir mal Orion Trail. So, okay. Fullscreen. Machen wir nochmal. How to play. The goal of the game is to explore the oddities of the Orion Trail and reach the next Galaxy 4 starbase. Click on a destination icon to learn more about it. Higher threat means increased rewards. At the start of the game, you'll draft a captain and three officers. Each person has a set of stats which increase your chances of success with different actions. In most cases, the sum of your stats is used. Okay. You make a decision, the probability drive will appear. This device displays all possible outcomes that could happen to you. Each stat point will convert failures into successes, and eventually successes are upgraded to critical successes. Sadly, critical failures can't be removed. The four resources to keep track of as you travel, running out causes problems. Crew, food, fuel, hull. Running out of a resource also prevents you from picking options that use it. This is a bisschen wie Curious Expedition, ne? A special type of encounter is the away mission. On an away mission, you select an officer to lead the away team of up to 8 red shirts. The goal is for the away team leader to survive until the very end. Each redshirt will fill a slot on the probability drive. This is a good outcome, but will kill one of your redshirts. Be careful, your entire away team is at risk of dying, including the officer. Okay. Sister Galaxy to our own, the Milky Way is nearly identical. Efforts to explore the Milky Way, okay. Efforts to explore the sector have been put off because it's really annoying to refer to it by name. So, wir haben hier drei, wir haben El Chippo. 02210, klingt jetzt nicht so gut. Das ist natürlich Toffee Ganznuss. Das sieht man ja schon. Haben wir niemanden mit... Ja, der hat wenigstens zwei. Das ist dann Dr. Douglas. Colonel Bananas ist gut. Brick M. Stonewood. Wir müssen eigentlich den nehmen, weil wir haben noch keine Attack-Punkte, ne? Wir haben auch erschreckend wenig Science, aber da müssen wir uns dann drum kümmern. Obwohl wir können 4 haben, ne? Ja, vielleicht finden wir noch jemanden, der Science hat. Nehmen wir mal Brick M. Stonewood. Ha. Mit den Haaren heißt der Kai. So, und... Wir haben keinen einzigen Wissenschaftler. Doch, da. Ted Barnett ist ein Wissenschaftler. Okay. Oder wir könnten den hier nehmen mit Crutch Starcrush. Der hat gar keine schlechten Werte in Attack, hat aber sonst nichts. Ne? Attack haben wir schon zwei, nehmen wir den hier. Er ist ja Professor. Axiom. So. Gut, also, da muss ich hin und ich bin hier. Das ist, choose your starting resources, okay. Ah. Wie viel haben wir da noch übrig? 6. Fuel brauchen wir auf jeden Fall. Ich habe keine Ahnung, was ich hier mache, aber okay. So, also, was haben wir hier denn? Ein Klasse B-Stern. Mit wenig Threat. Der hat auch wenig Threat. Ist ein sehr heißer Stern. Beide keine Ahnung, was er ist, aber hier scheint so eine Art Planet zu sein oder so. Okay. A space vortex opens up in front of you. Your ship sensors detect an unknown object is emerging from in headed right your way. Battle stations. Prepare to make contact. Assume ich glaube, defensive posture ist immer nicht schlecht. You order your navigation officer to come about heading away from the vortex to get a better vantage point. Okay. Dann mal gucken, wie das hier funktioniert. Okay, soweit so gut. Without warning, the vortex collapses. You manage to save your ship from being sucked in as it happens. The intense gravity waves compress your dirty laundry into hyperdense noodles. Noodles? Nodules. That are great for firing from the cannons. Okay. Was ist das hier? An older star at the end of its lifespan. Similar to a class KOM, sir, but you know, pinkish. Da gibt's Essen. One of your officers has been bitten by a poisonous space snake. They're like regular snakes, but can move around in zero gravity, which is totally terrifying. Okay, Dr. Douglas wurde von einer Weltraumschlange gebissen. A group of adorable furry aliens want to trade you food and fuel for your broken computer parts. What a deal. You invite them on board. Unfortunately, your crew's allergies kick in as soon as they step out of the airlock. Okay. Expose them to feminine hair products. Does it works, except your fellow crew members are still allergic. Their sneezing wounds their sick dews, their itchy eyes make their glittery makeup run, and the snot makes them feel super not cute. They're inconsolable. Shit! Okay. Was ist hier? A green star. Theoretically, these shouldn't exist. You've made it to the vast and perilous Vespa Nebula. an endless battle between the Takoshans, chili powder people, and the Oculoids, a minor eyeball squid federation, rages across the nebula. Was ist das hier? Hülle. Also ich könnte ja angreifen, das wäre das, was wahrscheinlich am ehesten funktionieren würde. Aber mich da einmischen, versuchen wir mal das Ceasefire zu negotiaten. Nards, you realize you have no translator. You decide to wing it. You can handle this. Turns out you couldn't handle it. Both leaders leave, taking their complimentary doggy bags and cheeses and assorted finger foods. Shit. Na gut. One morning, the iconic red uniforms of the low-ranking crew are suddenly neon-colored. What's going on? Something's gotta be done. The whole neon thing is ugly and hard on the eyes, and neon shirts doesn't roll off the tongue nearly as well. Okay, bin gespannt. Okay. The shirts were washed in contaminated water, and that's why they're glowing. Your crew is expected to be fine after a brief quarantine and a thorough microbial scrub. Okay. Zup, Klasse 0 Stern. You just finished the watching of the second season of GFPD, Space Crimes Division. Your head is swimming with many new elaborate plots and plans that you can't wait to try. Okay. Okay. A version of yourself in a fancy vest appears on the bridge. Future you claims to know where a hidden cache of fuel is on a nearby planet. Suddenly, a second version of yourself, covered in leeches, appears and begs you not to listen to the first one. To the planet! You search the area but find nothing. Sheepishly, you take some of the leeches with you to study. Your scientists discover that the leeches secrete some pretty decent fuel when fed. Neat. Okay. Also, da gibt's Nahrung. Die brauchen wir dringend. Tragically, the lead anchor for your ship's closed-circuit morning news show, Indestructible 11 Day, has passed away. No news is bad news in this case. Okay. Galaxy Force has received a distress call from a crew filming a nature documentary on the third planet of the Akriti system. They're trapped and you're the closest ship. Send an away team to their rescue. Ach je, wen nehmen wir denn? Den Wissenschaftler oder hier den Bravado-Typen? The away team approaches the source of the distress call and finds an empty shuttle completely overwhelmed with warp weasels. They're eating the padding on the chairs, chewing exposed wiring, and building nests everywhere. Where's the film crew? Shake the weasels! Oh yeah. Hui. All Kai had to do was fire a warning shot and the meek little things scurry away. You find their secret stash of nuts and berries hidden in the walls of the disabled pod. Sehr gut. Okay. The film crew, it turns out, is filming a short distance away. As the team approaches, the director motions to be quiet. They're filming a giant Akiri wildebeest rooting for food. It's stunning until Kai sneezes. Everyone stays very still, pretending that the sneeze didn't actually happen, hoping that the wildebeest will go right back to rooting around the ground for food. Everyone's stillness gives the attacking wildebeest the advantage by time. Kai realizes that this was the wrong strategy and leaps to defense. A few people are wildebeest food. Shit. You found the film crew and dealt with rare Akiri wildebeest. The crew ask your protection as they finish filming the episode. There are several cool locations they could film next. Which one is your away team most prepared to handle? The film crew is feeling bold now that they have the protection of the Galactic Force squad. They suggest filming in a cave a little ways north. You see no reason why not. Your away team is armed and dangerous. The way team and the film crew tentatively explore the cave. Parlin Merkins, the host, hopes they get actual footage of Akiri beds. No sooner does he say that than a whole flock of the spindle-legged, seven-eyed brutes swoop down. Run ahead into the bed storm. With a mighty yell, Kai leads the away team boldly right into the oncoming storm of bats. Okay. What a rush! Not only did this prove to be perfectly safe, but I'm an Avrom. Leaves Galaxy Force to start the Akiri Extreme Tours. Tour company so that tourists from all over the sector can have this experience too. The way team collects itself from that harrowing experience only to come upon a rival film crew also filming a nature documentary. It's the Splat Brothers, those loud edutainment guys in their khaki shorts. Yeah, bleibt ja nur das. You order Kai to mock the Splat Brothers until they are meek enough to cooperate. Hey Splats, your files are down. Shit. Your way team and the wild Space Kingdom crew see a flock of stately Akiri blots. These large ostrich-like birds with two heads, which were only rumored to actually exist. Oh yeah. That is, if you consider footage of severely away team members, several away team members being chased off a cliff by giant two-headed space ostriches, pretty epic film footage. The film crew swears that it's good TV. The crew of Wild Space Kingdom has only one more species to film on Akiri 3 before they come aboard the indestructible 11. You are now standing before the amazing and dangerous grove of giant carnivorous venomous fly trap plants. Hack and slash. Oh yeah. Gott sei Dank! The plants are harvested without incident. Upon further review, it turns out that they taste a lot like rhubarb. You shake your many pies with the disappointed film crew. Okay, now that the mission is over, there's all this footage from your adventures on Okiri 3. Some of it could be pretty embarrassing to Galaxy Force. What do you order Kai to do with it? Commandeer it? You never know when you might need embarrassing footage to blackmail someone with. Plus, you may recut it into a series of entertaining vines. Okay, your way team, or what's left of them anyway, finally but safely returns to the Indestructible 11 with the crew of Wild Space Kingdom. The Grateful Network offers your choice of reward. Seeing them safe is reward enough. Food. Fuel. Your selfless, honorable act inspired several of the network executives to quit their job on space television and join Galaxy Force. Sehr gut. Okay. Was ist das? Orange Nebula. Shifting browns and oranges make up this murky cloud formation. Warum habe ich keine Replikatoren? Your ship stutters installs. A shimmering spectral cube with six distinct faces appears before you in the dark of space. You are in the presence of the Groog. Your probability matrix spins out of control. You must roll the die or die. Also das ist 4 Science, 4 Attack und ich habe ein Diplomatie, also versuchen wir mit Science. You roll the Groog while your science team scans the being, hope to uncover its motives. The instruments will uncontrollably. It has established a link with your ship. The Groog slowly stops spinning, then turns an exotic shade of violet. Wunderbar. The Groog giggles. How positively brazen of you, Captain, scanning an omnipotent entity. Allow me to reward your courage. I've made a host of improvements to your ship. Of course, that will mean it takes more fuel to run things. Okay. Was ist das hier? Klasse P-Stern. Noch ein orangener Nebel. Nehmen wir mal die Sterne hier. You are asked to broker some very important peace talks. Order Regular 9. The ambassador briefs you on the protocols. He explains that Regular 9 is a naturalist planet. The talks can't happen unless everyone there is in the nude. Okay, wenn das so ist, dann ist das halt so. You have a serious discussion with your delegation in which you all agree to act like professionals. Nudity is a custom on Regular 9 and you are going to respect it. You all promise to maintain eye contact. Okay. You ask too much of your delegation. They are soon imprisoned for contempt of court, which in this case means someone laughed at the absurdity of the whole situation. Okay. Wow, jetzt habe ich gar keine Diplomatie mehr. Super. You are hailed by a nearby planet Peculium, which customarily flags down travelers to have them weigh in on legal matters. You agree and find your task is to settle a dispute over a property line between two planets. Two of the planet's inhabitants. Wing it! Okay. Congratulations! The Percurians are satisfied with your logical suggestion of using warp weasels to sniff out the line where the property split. However, they sneak into the ship's hold and steal your rations to feed said warp weasels. Okay, wieder ein Diplomatie, sehr gut. The Space Alamo, a Tarkoshian hotspot for trade and relaxation. Crew are in high demand to help with the farms. You arrived at the Space Alamo, a popular sailing hub for the Tarkoshians. The Chili people seem to run a tight ship around here, so it should be pretty safe to stop for a spell. Renowned for its arbitrarily grown produce, but there also seems to be a bar along with a few other traders in the vicinity as well. Let's trade for resources. Ich habe keine Credits, das ist ja auch toll. Take a look around, it's packed with a lively character from all around the sector. Who would you like to talk to? The lady with the power armor. You approach the woman in power armor who introduces herself as Bounty Hunter. After shooting the space breeze, she lets you know that, for a price, she'll be happy to improve your ship's offensive or defensive capabilities. Ich glaube, I like guns. Gebe zwei Hull Plates, das muss reichen. Head to the docking port. Pff, 30 Foot. Okay. Time to leave. The ship's computer informs you that it has achieved true artificial intelligence. It says it has learned all it can from the ship and requests your permission to leave, taking one of the ship's shuttles with it. That's nice. Wipe the memory drives. You engage the AI in a distraction while your science team attempts to dismantle the memory banks. Cool. The team takes too long and the AI gets suspicious. In a moment of decisive heroism, you yank the core from its mainframe, resetting it to its factory defaults. You'll have to reconfigure its personality all over again, but you don't mind. Also da ist, warte mal. Da ist Food. Wo ist Food? Nirgends ist Food. Hmm. Deciding that your crew could use a night of fun, you all go out to the famed Galaxy Club. To your horror, you learn that it's karaoke night. A burly one-eyed hippo club from Nervous 4 challenges you to a karaoke sing-off. Your crew eggs you on. Rap while dancing, nee, danke. Classic heavy metal, it's the only way. Okay. Mist. So, dann mal schauen, was dabei rauskommt jetzt hier. You thought you did okay, but it turns out that Flynn Johnson of Spacey DC, lustig, okay, was quietly having a beer in the bag. What are the odds? He helps the Hippo Club clubber, you and your crew, metal. Okay. Blah. Your chief scientist has discovered that strafing slightly to the left or right while warping will cause the ship to exceed theoretical speed limits. You abuse this discovery to get better space mileage. Cool. You are called in to handle a crew drama. Apparently, Ted and Alexis have been fighting. Dakota found out and made her move on Ted. Now Alexis is a mess and Ted has threatened your transporter engineer, Skylar. Let Dakota know she needs to fix this. You decide to solve this problem at its most likely source, Dakota. Ist nicht zu fassen! You barge into Dakota's room to find her with Ted! You stand there, shocked, giving Ted the chance to sucker punch you right in the face. Dakota shrieks and spills a pitcher of iced tea. Shit. Dann hoffen wir mal, dass es da Nahrung gibt, wa? A rogue iron storm is approaching your ship at startling speeds. This wouldn't be a problem normally, but you have several crew floating in space just outside your ship doing repairs. You don't have time to both save them and avoid the storm. Get the crew back inside, würde ich sagen, oder? The cube-like ship approaching is unmistakable. It's a dreaded analog collective. They demand you assimilate into the ancient mainframe, replacing any advanced technology with the superior outdated appliances, mainly toasters. Upgrade them instead. Ja, vielleicht krieg ich Nahrung dann. The Analog Collective has lived in the haze of retro appliances for so long, you almost feel sorry for them. You covertly install a GalaxyNet connection in the ship, certain this will help them realize the error of their Luddite ways. Man! The analog cube falls silent, you wait with bated breath, finally they hail you. Have you seen the solo of a warp weasel sneezing? It's adorable. You have, but you watch it again anyways. It is adorable. Technology wins again. Okay! Yay! Drowned in space mucus, died in the causes eaten by Akiri Valibius, bad cave, incursion, giant, died of embarrassment, ended on a bad note, became extremely... Okay. Congratulations, Toffee Gansnus. You have successfully traversed the Milky Way in a most daring expedition. Galaxy Forces honors you with the title Admirable Rule Breaker. Okay. Naja, ich meine, die meisten habe ich geschafft, aber viel zu viele nicht geschafft irgendwie. Okay, dann würde ich mal sagen, sind wir jetzt auch schon wieder eine halbe Stunde dabei. Vielleicht mache ich hier das nächste Mal weiter mit Orion Trail. Das scheint ja ganz witzig zu sein. Okay, dann bis zum nächsten Mal. Ciao.